dreads. It's like hair with a purpose. It's like what people do with tattoos. The power of the dreads.
Touchdown, Colorado!
I kind of like watching it blow in the wind when he runs in the end zone.
Everywhere we go, they say, oh, this dude with the dreads, this plate, that's number two. I think the dreads make him magic. That's how people, everybody knows me, honestly.
The dude with the dreads is Colorado wide receiver Laviska Shenault Jr. Laviska to his friends, the worst case scenario to his opponents. Laviska 10, 5, touchdown! Touchdown, Colorado!
It gives people nightmares. They put their best cover guy on him every week, and they can't cover that kid.
Freak of nature. He looks like LeBron James. When I saw him run, I was like, yeah, he's going to be dangerous.
Shenault grew up in the Dallas suburb of DeSoto, but his dad, Laviska Shenault Sr., raised him to root for the Miami Dolphins.
He was a diehard Dolphins fan. If Dolphins was losing, just know he was going to be an angry person in the house.
His dad was very active in sports with them, with the whole family, really. Very loving. He loved his kids.
On July 17, 2009, the Shenault family was returning home from a pool party in Irving, Texas. 10-year-old Viska sat in the front seat.
It happened so quick. It's something that kind of just edges in your mind forever.
I remember pretty much all of it, but yeah, I don't want to talk about that, honestly.
During the 30-minute trip, a tired Annie pulled over to let her husband drive.
As he was walking around in the car, he had on, you know, the slides, and they had been swimming, so he kind of like stumbled. And when he stumbled and got hit by the car, then got hit by another car.
Laviska Shenault Sr. died at the scene, leaving behind his wife and six children. He was 39.
It was such a traumatic thing for us. I know we all pulled together and we was hugging and holding each other. We just got together and said, we got to move on. So, you know, we got to move on.
I think I did grow up pretty fast after that.
Shortly after the funeral, a son decided to honor his father.
He was going to do dreads from now on. His dad did not have dreads, but we come from about biblical days where we grew up in the South, and it was like, your hair is your strength. He wanted to grow his hair.
Year by year, inch by inch, Shenault made good on his dreadlock promise. Then last season, as a true freshman, he made good on his first ever collegiate football touch.
The ball pops loose to Colorado, picks it up. Touchdown!
After his very first score, there was just one more thing to do.
I said, this is for you, Pop.
It's just like a dedication. I thank my Pop for just, you know, giving me the knowledge and understanding, the ability, the strength.
It's tough to grow up without a dad. But the way he's able to handle himself and handle all the fame that's coming his way right now, he knows who he is.
Shenault's dreadlocks are now 19 inches long and growing. So is his commitment to a memory.
The dreads represent family for Viska. They're connected with his father. I don't see him cutting his hair anytime soon.
I think it gives him strength, and I think it gives him encouragement, just remembrance. The longer they get, the stronger he gets. How about that?